wanted to plan not just a dental facility, but we wanted to plan a clinic that would be a beacon of light where it could provide a standard of care that could parallel the best standard of care that money could buy. So I thought, well, how could we possibly do that? I know, let's make a residency program. I wrote a letter to all the dental schools in the United States and Canada. And in the letter, I basically said, we have a new GPR, the first of its kind in Israel, and we are looking for students to apply. Within a very short period of time, I received a phone call from Mark Wagner.
I happened to see a notice in a magazine announcing a new residency program that was going to be starting up in Israel. I put in a call and I said, you know, I'm going to be in Israel. Is there anything I can do to help you? And Dr. Pearl, for those who know him, doesn't miss a beat, said, would you care to come up to Boston and let's talk about this?
I'm, again, this young dentist who's teaching one afternoon a week at Harvard in oral diagnosis, and he's the chairman of the department with a CV that's about 30 pages long, and I'm interviewing him for this position.
They wanted me to come up and really get the program off the ground. And I said, well, how much time would it take?
Here I am thrilled that I have somebody of the stature of Mark Wagner who's interested in a residency program. On the other hand, he's only there for 6 months. What do we do now? So you have to think quick in these types of situations. And I said, well, if you can find somebody else for the second 6 months, then we'll consider you for the first 6 months.
Just so happened that Dr. Morgenstein was planning a sabbatical to begin in January. Would he consider it? Well, I figured I can't talk Dr. Morgenstein into it, but I'm sure Dr. Pearl could. Lo and behold, the sabbatical built for two, the tandem sabbatical was created. I would go the first 6 months and Dr. Morgenstein would go the second.
Izzy saw a tremendous, tremendous need for dental care. I think the need was all over the city, all over the country probably, but particularly in the area where the clinic was on Rehov Bucharim, near the old city. And Mark would send me letters every now and then telling me about his shock at seeing the level of need that the children had at the time. And then when I got there, I saw Mark was not exaggerating.
We started seeing 7 and 8 year old children with bombed out molars and couldn't figure out exactly why that was happening until one day we had a seminar at Hadassah. And I remember Mark Wagner asking some of the faculty there about it. And they explained to us that these families who have very large families, a lot of children, have very little food for their children. And they'd buy 2 loaves of bread, let's say, in the morning for their kids. The kids would get a slice of bread, and that's all they would have for most of the day. And what they did was they took that bread and they would suck on it, putting it up in their cheeks for the entire day.
When you're dealing with an indigent population, the last thing that they think about is taking care of teeth in their mouth and their oral hygiene. They may not have the wherewithal to do it. They may not have toothbrushes. They may not have parents who think about, you know, telling their kids to brush their teeth.
Well, let me put it this way. We started with 12 children the first day. By the time Dr. Morgenstein got there, our waiting list for an appointment was 4 weeks.
The opening ceremony was a very moving event. This had been a labor of love to set up the clinic for me.
At a brief meeting with Rav Shlomo Tzvi Weiss, the idea of a dental clinic for underprivileged children was born.
This was a quintessential Israeli ceremony where there was so much hope and so much riding on what was going on here.
My father was there, good friends were there, Dr. Steinberg was there, the mayor of Jerusalem was there, the Boston Rebbe was there, and many other dignitaries and community leaders were there. It was just a very, very special event. Teddy Kollek, I still remember what he said. He said, a few years ago, this dentist from Boston, Dr. Pearl, approached me to make a nonprofit dental clinic for poor children. Lots of Americans come with ideas. Let's see what's doing in 10 years. Okay. Well, now we're 25 years later. Let's see what's doing.
Thank you.
5 years ago, my wife and I were visiting Jerusalem. I said to my wife, let's go visit the clinic. I just had a feeling that it was something I wanted to do. I walked in and Judy came out right away to welcome me, introduced me to some of the patients, and that was when she told me that the clinic was moving.
We were outgrowing the facility. It was time for an upgrade. The patients were just amazed with the beauty of the clinic, the friendliness in the clinic, and the warm atmosphere in the new facility.
I've been a patient in Lubislum for 22 years. I first came to Lubislum when I was a teenager and I brought my younger brothers and sisters. And when I got married, I started to bring my children. And now, I'm bringing my 8-month-old baby to the new Mother and Baby Oral Health Center.
It's important to come to our Mother and Baby Oral Health Center. We want to teach the mother how to start healthy and good habits. Bringing your child as early as possible to the dentist will achieve a caries-free generation.
Since in Israel, many children, especially those at a low socioeconomic status, do brush their teeth only once or twice a week and do not even have their own toothbrush. I mean, one toothbrush is being used at home by 3, 4, or sometimes 5 children. Our short-term goals are, first of all, bringing the patients, especially children, into a minimal level of awareness and understanding about their mouth. Our actions are being adapted constantly to the Israeli different cultures and habits in order to improve our influence on the families through the children at the clinic and at the kindergarten.
I never would have thought back in 1985 that we would be celebrating its 25th anniversary today.
We started with no patients. We started with no clinic. We didn't have any supplies or equipment.
Starting with a staff of about 5 in the beginning with a budget of $80,000 to a staff of 45 with a budget of about $1.2 million. I guess that's what we're doing. I just can't.